quiet during this ceremony. Hi, everyone. We are going to do the BoF wrap-up for the very first Akademy Day of 2017. We've had lots and lots and lots of BoFs, so I'm going to call you up one at a time, and I'd like each BoF session to put someone right here on the spot to tell us all what you've achieved or what you've decided, or maybe that you sat around and enjoyed the air conditioning. It's not in room 2.5. I'm going to start with the BoFs from room 2.2. Anu. Is not here. The playing with an amalgam of QML and JavaScript. Anyone here? Oh, there's John. He can accompany.
So we had a wee workshop, and there were half a dozen of us there, and Anu and Vasadu showed us their work with QML, which is mostly on Rakula, the new chat application. And they gave everybody a bit of an introduction to QML, and I started off on a bit of QML for the installer, which will be added into Calamaris, which Jens wants us to have, which gives us sort of first run setup installer experience, which I'm very skeptical about, but it's nevertheless fun to play with in QML.
Bits are news to me. Next up is Paul Brown with Say What? He's not here. Did everyone remember to check their egos at the door before that BoF? Oh. Man, you were everywhere.
So Paul gave a talk the other day, which nearly ended up in a fist fight to the death, about how we introduce people to particular products through their initial web pages. And so he was doing a similar exercise, and we looked at KDE.org and whether or not that actually gives useful messages to the people who would go to KDE.org, and we compared it to Mozilla.org and a couple of other places, and said that they were all a bit rubbish, but Mozilla.org was less rubbish than us, and that we should learn stuff from other places like them to ensure that we're actually marketing stuff in a way that talks to the people that it should talk to.
Okay, next up in room one was lunch. I'd remind you all to say no to gazpacho. And next say yes to Gabriela Ponzo and her legal office.
We just have a presentation about our community and the foundation, the document foundation, which is behind the project LibreOffice, and how to become a member of the foundation after being a member of the community, obviously, and why to be a member of the document foundation, mostly to drive the governance of the foundation to vote or to be voted. And more or less, that's it. And I hope to be able to have many new members in our community and hopefully in our foundation, maybe among you as well. Thank you.
Hi, Franklin, you had a BoF on migrating FOSS and KDE. Give us a minute while
vendors, or we have community supporting here, so that it would be easier or it would be more possible to make our government open and to use free software. So we discussed some problem of this as a maybe I hope that including KDE, including PDF, or even Mozilla, more open source and free software community can join together to make this solution available. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Franklin. Moving on to room 2.3, which looks kind of, it was plasma all day.
You need to stand there.
Push on, please.
So we had a whole day of plasma BoF. So first topic was our plasma's reason. So before a few days before the Academy, we finalized our plasma reason. So
let's wait for him.
So we discussed about our vision and what to do next about it and about that. Then next topic was about plasma mobile. So for plasma mobile, we discussed how can we have a proper collaboration with the other community who are working on mobile technologies, mobile on Linux on mobile devices already. For example, Ubiquit, self-service, and we also discussed the topics about convergence. And later on, David had a topic about unifying our QML imports, or that he can present those topics.
So, the afternoon was a very technical talk. We have a lot of the frameworks that have gone a bit mouldy, because when they were written, we didn't have QQuick Controls 2, we didn't have QGadget, and we didn't have Kiragami. So all of the QML imports across Plasma and K Declarative have ended up in slightly obscure places. We now have a plan of where everything is going to eventually end up, some cleaner roles assigned to all of the different parts, and a bit of slaying is going to happen. We come up with a list of things we need to upstream in Qt to make Qt controls to actually work for us, and move forward with that. After that, we had a talk about OpenQA with Harold, who's...
What? Oh, for fuck's
sake. Who's prepared?
Yes, absolutely. So we talked about OpenQA, which is a lovely QA solution made by our friends at SUSE. And having done a lot of work in the area of integration and acceptance testing, I've come to the conclusion, and we've sort of agreed on that, that OpenQA can be part of the solution, but it's not going to solve all our problems. In fact, what we want is a two-pronged approach. It's OpenQA for the asserting the visual state of something, and accessibility testing to test the functionality of something. And I think that should be a good solution, and that should be really awesome and prevent regressions moving forward. Yes!
Alright, and Gabriela had a second leader talk.
Yes, it was. Before I start, I had a second BoF with Cisco Fauli, and it was about the announcement of the 5.4 LibreOffice version, which would be released within 2 days, and we just made the announcement in advance for you. It's coming soon, probably for you. And by the way, we just have shown the most new features coming with this new version. And a little bit more question and answer as well. Thank you.
application developer story. That's yours. It's Kevin.
So that was a follow-up on the talk we gave with David the day before on how to improve our developer story or the previous world, starting with frameworks all the way to apps. And we've been looking at the make install problem, how we can solve it, and that should be pretty much under control for most cases. Now it's just about to do the actual work. And we've also been looking a bit more at Conan and how it could fit for helping new developers to join and automatically getting the dependencies they need to work on to make that path easier. And shortly, that's not strictly in the meeting, but shortly after the meeting, Frederick actually did a prototype of that. So we have K-Archive, which has been packaged for Conan, to our first one. And you need a small prototype, just a simple app using K-Archive and pulling that from Conan. So that's off to a good start.
Next up, Luigi Toscano and the translation BoF.
Yeah, so we touched a few topics which have been hot in the translation community for a while and well known even in the past academies, and which unfortunately are not easy to fix without much manpower, but at least we identified which things we should do related to the website, online translation, but that's something which will come later. To the structure of the files, to the structure of the files on the repository, on the usage of CoSummit to simplify the life of the translator, and few things are interconnected, and we have like at least 2 or 3 years of work for many people, but we will try to make it work somehow. And if you would like to have something to contribute in Python just to change a bit from C++, just contact us and we will see how to do it.
Towards the end of the day in that room, we have Augustine and the KDE Automotive. Let's plant some goalposts. Talk.
Okay, so after my lightning talk yesterday, the first question that needed to be solved today is there interest in approaching the automotive sector? The conclusion of the BoF is yes. The second one is, can we do something credible in a fairly short period of time? So we explore there 3 lines of work. One of them seems very feasible, the other 2 needs to be analyzed in the coming weeks. The good news is that there are people that can do that and that is willing to do that. So probably in a few weeks we will be able to say if we can do something in the short term that good enough to approach and explore the automotive environments that are out there now becoming popular.
And the last BoF I could find on the schedule, let's welcome our very own evil overlord, Lydia, to tell us. The henchman of our evil overlord.
Right, so we're not fighting to summarize this one because a lot of things were discussed and it's a bit complicated, so let me take my notes. So basically after a bunch of people got drunk last night, they got a number of ideas, and today, without the alcohol, we're trying to discuss these ideas in more details. One of them was the idea of changing the format of the General Assembly by moving out of the General Assembly all of the reports from the working groups. Basically, all the stuff that happens in the working group is not, it doesn't have to be private to the EV, it could be part of Academy and be part in a presentation so that people can more easily first know what's happening and also possibly join these efforts. A possible side effect of that might be that the assembly becomes short enough to fit into another day than the Friday before the weekend. It could then become something for the Monday morning, maybe. But that still has to be checked whether it's actually possible. But at least the idea of making things more public sounds like a good step forward. After that, we discussed a number of things that might help lowering the barrier of entry, not talking about the developer story, but more about the community. So there isn't like a one magic idea in that respect, but it was one of the things that came out was we learned that there is this possibility in, so to fix the problem of huge threads, for instance, on the EV mailing list, where everyone feels that they have to contribute, even to say not much of substance. The idea was that it seems to be possible with Mailman to have the plus one, minus one type feature on emails. I have no idea how that works, but apparently it's possible to say I agree or I disagree without giving details. Okay. And yeah, a number of other ideas. Ideas like, as you might know or not, the EV board has in the past already set up something they call office hours, like, you know, we're available to answer to your questions, so that's already something that exists. But the idea was put forward that possibly working groups could do the same and try to be available for more public communication and other ideas like that. Now, the third thing is the most important. I think we discussed a lot about the idea of the community together setting up goalposts, as in sort of directions we want to go forward to in the next year or two. And the idea of that is to have a system where people can submit ideas and say, I think we should go in that direction, I think we should work on input method, and I think we should work on the developer story, I think we should work on whatever, right? If possible, things that are sort of across the board rather than we should work on one feature in one application, right? And these ideas will be collected and then submitted to a vote by the whole set of contributors, right? This is, we're not talking about the EV anymore, this is about all the contributors to KDE, possibly even all the users. And the idea was put forward to basically have the two set of people voting, and we can check what it is we want to work on and what it is other people would like us to work on, and see if there is anything that would even work for both ideally. So the idea of the vote there is simply to let people sort this idea by preference, right? It's not about picking one thing, it's more about setting some things as having more priority than others. And then if we collect all of that together, we can say, okay, for the next year, we will have these two or three proposals that have been sort of accepted by the community. And what that actually means is that the people who have submitted this, and the idea was not one person, but more like a group of three or four developers who are interested in that. They, because their idea has been accepted, that means they will have the opportunity to organize a sprint around that idea, and they will also get a slot for a presentation at the next Academy where they can present the current status of that project and possibly get more people to contribute. So yeah, it's a bit of a revolutionary idea. Everyone in the room seems to agree it's a good idea, but of course the next step is to take this back to the KDE community mailing list and see what other people think about it, and sort of discuss in a wider forum this whole idea. But of course this is not about, you know, we're not turning KDE into a company where if you don't do what you're told then you're out. This is not at all about that. I see it more as a way to, instead of everyone working on their own little thing in their own silo, sort of having a way to brainstorm ideas, and then once we pick a few ideas, have people rally a code and work together on something which gives us a bit more direction and purpose than, you know, me hacking on this because it seems fun but nobody cares, right? It's all about having this this common brainstorming towards common goals, which in my opinion used to happen when we were like 30 people in 2003 meeting at a KDE meeting, which wasn't academic, there wasn't a presentation, so we would just, you know, go into a room and talk about the most important problems. But now you can't do that with 500 people, so instead the idea is let's do it over the internet, have a vote, make it a bit more structured, and pick the things that we are interested in for the next year, and then reevaluate, of course.
Thank you, David. I would like to subscribe to your newsletter. Okay, last thing is, I'd like to remind you that KDE rocks, and tomorrow we are going to rock the Casbah. After the BoF wrap-up tomorrow, there will be the opportunity to go to Al-Kazabah here in Almeria and see the fortress. If you're an EU citizen, bring your passport because that's free.
Yeah, don't rub it in.
So we'll see you tomorrow again. Have a good evening.